every day.
Welcome everyone to another episode of High Noon with Jess. And Jo is not with us tonight. She is actually off, I believe, at a family reunion, so that's super exciting. Family's awesome.
Yes.
So
and
we
important.
We absolutely wish she could be here, but who doesn't want to be with family whenever they can be? Right. So we don't blame her for missing out. But I know that she is blaming herself for missing out because this is my friend Skye.
Hello.
Skye Shepard. She is going to be our highly esteemed guest for the evening. She has welcomed us into her apartment. And she is doing something a little special for us this evening because she's actually going to be our first edibles guest.
Ah.
I'm very excited. I'm a little nervous. My stomach is not actually the best with edibles, generally speaking.
Oh, okay.
That's usually only if I can, like, prominently taste or smell the cannabis.
Good to know.
So hopefully you're a good chef.
Yeah.
But I think it's going to go well because Skye's making something a little funky and unique. She's making a smoothie. Ooh, an edible smoothie.
Yeah.
So tell me, my experience with edibles is more in like the brownies, cookies, you know, baked variety,
right.
Which I believe mostly utilizes can of butter of some kind, breaking the cannabis down into the plant down into like an oil of some kind that they then mix in with the ingredient that is already needed, which is butter, or I think it's been mixed in other ingredients as well, but I'm not really
the most
chef.
Common one.
Butter, okay.
Yeah.
Can of butter, most common. But since we're making a smoothie, no butter is needed, I presume.
No. It is. I'm going to use an edible.
Okay.
This is an edible I got from Jamaica, so it is more so. Theirs is a little
Jamaican
different.
Edible?
Yeah, there's a little different. They actually ground, you could taste more of the weed grounded.
Okay. Okay.
But it was just like a cake.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you're going to use an already formed edible that you're just going to break up in La Blender, I assume.
Yeah.
And you're going to make it not terrible to my stomach by masking it.
Right. I don't like the smell and taste of most edibles, so that's why I usually mask it with. Bananas are like a great masking of anything. So if you have anything left over, like in your freezer, or like you're trying to get rid of it, and you can make it into a smoothie, just freeze these.
Oh, is that what the bag is?
This is a bag of frozen bananas. Take the peel off.
You have a lot.
Yes, I tell you, I do
stockpiled bananas
all the time. This is my go-to like meal. And then like the banana, you make sure it's like more ripe than this because the riper it is.
Oh yes.
More sweet, and so
yes.
You don't have to sweeten it with anything else.
I love
it. And it usually masks the taste
banana.
Of roast dough. So, yeah.
I'm so excited.
Add kale to this so you don't have to taste kale. You know, like just put anything with banana and you're good.
Okay, so I'm totally inept when
cool.
it comes to the kitchen and when it comes to the edibles.
That's kind of why I got into smoothies, because I was like, how do you cook for real? So, yeah.
A smoothie seems like an easy recipe to conquer.
Yep, you just throw things in there so I get started.
So, yeah, get started, please.
Cool.
I'm hungry. Crew?
Yeah.
Yeah, crew is hungry.
Cool.
It is about dinner time for those of you in the area right at this moment while we're filming instead of watching later on YouTube on a totally different time. So, milk, that's the start.
Yeah, I'm using almond milk.
Ah, almond milk. Thank you. I was just having a conversation with my boyfriend about like the travesty of dairy milk and like in all sorts of ways, the inhumanity of it all and the like torturousness of it all and just the actual like weirdly unhealthy and like not biological aspect of it all.
Yeah.
I don't understand
growing up
dairy
Texas,
farmers, like, you got a little carried away. A little carried away. So almond milk.
Yeah.
I'm so excited.
That's a nice alternative.
I've been trying to, like, kick the habit, you know? Because my taste buds and my brain are just still so inclined to go for some
regular milk,
whole milk, and some the cereal, and it's just like, as you put almonds and you almond milk, you taste almonds, and it's a little weird. But I need to test around with it.
Try. You should after this. You should try a glass. It tastes
just
really
one.
Good. Tastes really good.
I'm gonna chase my smoothie with a glass of almond milk. So you've put in bananas.
Bananas.
How many bananas have just gone into the gullet?
Two
full bananas.
Two
full bananas. And about how much milk is that? That seems like a lot.
It's a lot.
We're making four smoothies. BT dubs. This is not just for us. We have two crew members behind the scenes. Our 4 a.m. gents.
Measure.
You know? Yeah, they're
there. I should measure, but I don't. This is just natural.
Did you hear what she just said? I should measure, but I don't.
We're winging it, right?
I mean, if it works and it comes out right, no fault to you not measuring.
She said, if. You heard that?
Well, if.
If it comes out right.
I'm gonna taste test it for sure, and then I'll let you know. So, and I believe you indicated to me before we started shooting that this is also by no means measured.
Nope.
Like, that we don't know
I don't,
exactly how much we are putting in terms of THC. Now, I would absolutely recommend that when you consume edibles on a normal basis, you should probably know how much you're ingesting. That's a good idea.
Yeah.
You don't want to over-ingest, and it's so easy to over-ingest when you're dealing with edibles, especially if you were to make edibles with the tinctures, which is like a totally different, easier way to make edibles nowadays than, like, doing the whole melting down into the oil yourself that you then mix into the butter, like, that's a whole process.
Yeah.
And this kudos to you if you know how to do that and can do it successfully. But for those of us who are inept, the tinctures are a really quick, little like segue to just get there so smoothly.
This is how much I usually just.
But you can overdose so easily.
Yeah.
The cakes, because you've ingested it already, you kind of know, like, how many bites you need. That's helpful. Taste test, or, you know, drip drop test your stuff before. You just put, she's putting brownie bites in now.
It's
not the edible anymore.
I usually put like cocoa, but they didn't have any at the store, but this is.
I will be fine with brownie brittle. Just one? Yeah. I'll take that. Thank you.
Go for it. It has salted caramel. So we're going to get it going and taste it, and then if we need more of something, we'll add some more.
So she is going to do it. Don't do it yet because we're still filming and we won't be able to be heard if you turn.
And this thing's really loud too.
So she will mix that up in our break. We'll get them poured out and we'll start sipping on them in our next segment. And obviously, because we wanted to focus on what was going on, we didn't get into Skye's experience with cannabis at all thus far. So in the next segment, when we get the smoothies in hand and we start actually consuming cannabis, we'll talk to Skye about her experiences. We'll start with the beginning, just like we always do with your first experience.
Let me tell you.
And then we'll come to the now and we'll get as much of the now in as we can before we move to the third segment. And then we'll talk about the future, and that'll be it for tonight, and it'll be lovely.
Cool.
So thank you, everyone, who's joining us at home. Hopefully you have a smoothie in hand yourself, or your own edible of choice, or just a bowl that you packed. I almost said rolled. You don't roll bowls. until next time. Or if you vape, vape in hand. Peace and love.
Smoke the weed. Every day, don't smoke the seeds, no way. Smoke the weed, hey, smoke the weed.
Younger generation,
boys and girls,
be careful of the seeds you show. If you want to see a strong tree grow,